I'm Jason Christensen. I'm the president and owner of Christensen Arms. My father started the company in 1995, and it was based on the backbone of both the prosthetics industry and also in the aerospace industry. And we knew that if we could take the things we learned in those industries and those great materials and processes, and we move them over to a firearms company, that we could build the best firearms in the world. Great products are generally boiled down to a really strong manufacturing process, and controlling those processes at every step, controlling the materials that you have come in, and then doing that same thing every time, the exact way you proved out that it could. And as we think of our gun barrels, and as they come through the system, they go through a new manufacturing cell where we tightly control the tools to make sure they're sharpened on certain intervals, and then we check those tools, and then as the barrels come off, we bore scope the barrel, and we continually check that process, and we make sure that those things are going through. And then right on down the line, as we make that gun stock is made exactly the same way every time. When you build products for the aircraft industry, you can't do what you want. You have to do exactly the same thing every time. And that's how you build an aircraft that, you know, can fly and be safe. At aerospace precision that we do, we're putting that into the products we do here at Christensen Arms. And when we use these great materials that have these great features and functions and benefits, as we put those into these products, and then we use the same methods that we use in the aerospace company, it allows us to drive a better product, a different product than anyone else can do. We always focus on the things that will allow you to create lightweight, stiff structures that will meet the engineering requirements you have for the product. And so in our high temp barrel applications, we use something that's proprietary to us, but it comes from a space system that is used on satellites right now. And the reason we use something that's on a current platform is we know the testing is done when we buy that material. It arrives here, it's already been through a whole lot of testing to prove that it's safety of flight and safety for safe for space. The strength of composites is in the direction that the material is going. And so in a barrel application, if we run the materials down the length of the barrel, that adds all that stiffness going straight down the length. And for us, that's what we're going for. We're going to control that barrel width. We wanted to create the stiffest possible structure we could that would allow for the lightest possible structure. And we've accomplished that, and it works very well. We have a very optimized barrel for that. But then as you think how you'd use that in a gun stock, and in aircraft for that matter, you put the stiffness and the strength only where you need it, and then you don't put anything else there. And you try and come up with this optimized engineered solution that meets the stiffness and the strength criteria, but then also isn't extremely expensive. And that's what we try to do as composite engineers. You try and find that right mix of where you need the strength and where, how light do you really need it, and then you use the appropriate materials for that. By having an aerospace company and a firearms company, we're able to find a lot of great new materials, or it may not even be a new material, it just may be using an old aerospace material in a new application in the firearms industry. One example of that is in the aerospace industry, the molds we use are made out of Invar, which is high nickel content steel. Now the benefit of that is that it has a very low coefficient of thermal expansion. And so as we're curing composites, if the mold grows and the composite materials are on there and then they take the shape when the mold has grown, you now have something that you may not have planned for in the shape. And so in the aerospace industry for years, they've used Invar. Invar doesn't grow under temperature during certain amount of temperature. As we think of firearms, we sure use a lot of aluminums. Now aluminums, they grow a lot. You know, they grow a lot under temperature. And as we thought of the bedding pillars, we thought that if they are moving under temperature, this is just one less thing that you will have to worry about. And so we said, well, let's use the Invar that we use in our molds. And then as you see a temperature difference, whether you go from inside your truck to the heat of the desert, or the other side of that, as you go, you know, from camping in the cold to open airplanes or whatever it is, that Invar should keep its original length during that whole time, and therefore you don't see that cycling of your pillar, which may lead to inaccuracy. So we're doing everything we can to try and eke out just that much more precision or accuracy out of these rifles. We're just trying to continually make a better product for the customer that can help them be successful in whatever they're trying to do, whether that's punching paper, shooting targets, or that once-in-a-lifetime big hunt. We want to create a product that really can make a difference for them.